Chapter 8, The Party. Song on the blackboard. Let me try to sing this. We love you, Miss Ribble. Written and arranged by Tara Ribble. Oh, well, it's a song called We Love You, Miss Ribble. Anyway, I thought I was supposed to sing it, but oh, here's a song. We love you, Miss Ribble. Oh, yes, we do. We don't love anyone as much as we. Oh, as much as you. When you retire, we'll be blue. Oh, Miss Ribble. Mrs. Ribble's retirement party started off bad and just got worse. First, Miss Ribble forced the class to sing a corny song to her. By the time she was done yelling at the boys for singing off key, the chunky tofu ice cream was melted. Why would anyone give a party for her? That's what I want. Everybody had to eat it anyway. Then the children handed in their happy retirement cards. Miss Ribble, that evil coward. Miss Ribble ripped several of the cards up because some of the children has mistakenly drawn polka dots on their butterflies. One unfortunate boy had also drawn a half smiling sunshine on his card, and he had to stand in the corner. Finally, Mr. Krupp stepped forward and handed Miss Ribble the card he had snatched from Harold's hand. I went to a lot of trouble to get this for you, Mr. Krupp said gallantly. Well, he's in for a big surprise. Miss Ribble tore the envelope open and read the card out loud. You're one hot mama, said Miss Ribble with a shocked look on her face. Ew, cried the children. She opened the card and read the inside. Will you marry me? Signed, Mr. Krupp. Cried the children. The teachers gasped. Then the room grew silent. Mrs. Kribble glared over at Mr. Krupp, who had turned bright red and began sweating profusely. He tried to speak. He tried to tell her it was all a big mistake. He tried to say something, but all that came out was congratulations, said Mr. Meaner as he patted Mr. Krupp's sweaty, shivering shoulder. Yes, congratulations. Yes, congratulations, shouted Miss Anthrop. This will be the best wedding in the whole world. We can have it here at the school. A week after Saturday, I'll plan everything. You lovebirds don't have to worry about a thing. Great, thanks, said Miss Ripple. Still looking quite angry and confused. What? Said Mr. Krupp.